In this tutorial, we are going to learn how to define the number of sketch lines and further control and art direct their intensity either globally or locally. I'm Henriette from Art Engineering and we develop artist-driven tools for stylized rendering. Let's get started. In the tutorial series overview, we learned how to set the sketch style and how the feature noise within Flair materials is required for sketch lines to appear. Now it's time to go deeper and learn how to set the number of sketch lines and control their intensity. Global sketch attributes can be modified through the Flair Globals node. To select it, go to the Flair shelf and click on the globe icon. This will select the node and open up Maya's attribute editor where you will find the sketch globals. The main sketch lines attribute controls the number of sketch lines you want to have, from none, one, or two sketch lines. Sketch lines can also be combined with normal toon lines to have a total of three lines. However, keep in mind that the toon line will draw over the sketch lines as it normally happens during cleanups. The sketch intensity attribute controls the opacity of the sketch lines by either making them more transparent or fully opaque. This is useful when you wish to have subtle sketch lines throughout the scene. However, this would not be Flair if the sketch intensity could not be further art directed with VertexFX, NoiseFX, and Proxies. For example, you might want to reduce the intensity of sketch lines on highly detailed parts of objects to reduce the mush of lines that would otherwise be generated. For this purpose, you can open the VertexFX tool, select the objects in question, decrease a sketch intensity effect using the slider, and paint less sketch intensity, like here. You can also increase the intensity in parts that you want to look darker, like this. If you're not a sketchy person, give us a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to our channel with the bell icon to be notified about future tutorials like this one. Back to art directing. Noise effects can also be used to speed up the art direction process and add intensity fluctuations throughout the object, like so. With proxies, you can also make entire sketch parts of the 3D scene lighter to bring focus to different elements. If you wish to learn all about the art direction tools, make sure to check out the learning material in the description below. This wraps up the first sketch tutorial, where we learned how to change the number of sketch lines, art direct intensity of the sketch lines globally, and set out to fully control the sketch intensity with all the art direction tools within Flair. In the next tutorial in this series, we will learn how to control the width of sketch lines and art direct them globally and locally. The width controls are the same as the toon lines, so if you've already seen the toon line tutorials and feel comfortable art directing the width of lines in Flair, feel free to skip to the sketchiness tutorial instead. Thank you for watching this far! If you love what we're doing, make sure to purchase a commercial license or become our Patreon to use Flair without resolution limitations and have your name appear in this beautiful list of credits. Let's widen things on the next one.